Good morning from NASA's Johnson Space Center. This is Mission Control Houston. You're looking from the back of the room, looking forward at the International Space Station Flight Control Room. A team of flight controllers watching over all of the systems on this Monday, March 12th. From these flight control positions, monitoring systems aboard this station since about 7 o'clock this morning, U.S. Central Daylight Time. The team operates on about 9-hour shifts, monitoring all of the systems aboard the station and the timeline of the expedition crew aboard. Today, the team is led by veteran flight director Royce Renfrew. He's serving as flight director on this shift. He's joined by Josh Matthew, who's serving as the spacecraft communicator, the link, the voice link between this team and the crew aboard the International Space Station. That crew aboard the station, which is currently circling the Earth about every 92 minutes at an altitude of 250 statute miles, heading out across the Pacific Ocean. The station about to move into an orbital sunrise as it heads toward the southern tip of California. We'll make a pass across the Midwest of the United States and then out across Canada. The crew on board Expedition 30 is commanded by astronaut Dan Burbank. He's joined by the two colleagues that he arrived at the station with back in November of 2011, Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin. Those three crew members have been aboard the station for 119 days now. They've been in space for 121 days. They're headed for a 168-day stay in space on this Expedition 30. Also joined by three other crew members, Oleg Kononenko, Andre Kuipers from the Netherlands, and U.S. astronaut Don Pettit. Those three arrived at the station back just before Christmas of 2011. They now have been aboard the station for 81 days and in space now for 83 days. Burbank, Shkaplerov, Ivanishin plan to return home in April. And the other three crew members, Kononenko, Kuipers, and Pettit, are scheduled to return home around early July. The crew members wake up about 1 o'clock in the morning, U.S. time, Central time, and immediately get into early morning preparatory activities, looking around the station, doing an inspection, and then they hold a daily planning conference with the teams around the world on here on the ground to set the stage for their work on orbit, the work focusing on experiment activities in the various laboratories that make up the International Space Station complex. One of the focuses of attention is by Don Pettit, who is spending quite a bit of his time on an experiment known as SLICE, which is the Structure and Liftoff in Combustion Experiment. He's been working with that for a number of days back in the laboratory. It's housed inside the Microgravity Sciences glove box and studies the nature of flames in the microgravity environment.
Station Moscow, SG-1 for Oleg.
Additionally, last week, the crew members supported activities with the robotics refueling mission of the station. That RRM was the focus of attention with the robotics operations, including the Canadarm2, and the dexterous manipulator, the special purpose dexterous manipulator known by Dexter. Was a very successful operation. Everyone was pleased with that. In fact, the International Space Station Mission Management Team met earlier, and there were quite a number of congratulations all the way around in support of that RRM operations. The next activity with the RRM is scheduled in May, when some additional work will be performed using the same robotic operations. So the crew spending a very busy day on the first day after a weekend that the crew saw some rest, and we'll spend the rest of the week working with science investigations aboard the International Space Station. This is Mission Control Houston.